Ooh. What's this? What's this? Water. Water's good. Waves. Waves are also good. Wait. No. No. It isn't. There's no way. It's definitely not a thing I was aware of. This is definitely the first time I'm reacting to this, and not just for YouTube's sake, for sure. What? Everyone is super surprised. To be fair, I actually was surprised, though. I didn't expect there to actually be a remake of Link's Awakening. Although I'm ecstatic, I had heard the rumors and kind of just went, yeah, I wish. Kind of like I did with Majora's Mask 3D and Ocarina of Time 3D. Huh. For those of you who don't know, Link's Awakening has been and always will be one of my favorite games of all time. It was the first game I ever bought, and it's very dear to my heart. So with that being said, I don't care how bad this remake could be, I am nothing but ecstatic for it. It's going to be giving me more of something that's absolutely one of my favorites. Even if it is an absolute garbage game, I will still be super happy to just have a little more of this. As far as I'm concerned, there are no downsides to this. A lot of times when people make these remakes, people are really concerned with, oh, but is it true to the original? I don't care. I have the original. This is just going to be something new, and I'm just really excited about that. I've already seen in the comments some people are a little sad that it's not going to be a brand new game, but the original came out about 25 years ago. The non-color one, now I've played the DX version, so it came out a little more recently than that, but this is a very, very old game. So why Link's Awakening? What makes Link's Awakening special? I'm not gonna lie, a lot of it is nostalgia. One of the things that really sets apart Link's Awakening is its quirkiness. It's such a weird Zelda game, and I mean that in the nicest way possible because I love it. It's just so much more bizarre than any of the previous other entries. Everything from the dinky music to waking up and finding chain chomps as dogs to finding piranha plants and literally stomping on Goombas. This game is very weird. They even have Kirby's that suck you in called anti-Kirby's, really creative name, Nintendo. And it looks like, looking at this trailer, they actually kept most of that in. You're seeing the chain chomp dogs, you're seeing the Goombas, they're actually official Goomba-looking things, more so than just kind of resembling Goombas. I'm really happy that they kept this the way it was, instead of trying to keep it at its roots. It's something I've been noticing with Nintendo lately, is that they keep trying to go back to their roots and cut out excess things and make it very pure, and I like that they're allowing this one to be its quirky, weird mess that it was. You saw with Paper Mario Color Splash how the game was damaged by being forcibly kept only to normal Nintendo enemies, and things like that ruined a lot of the charm that the series had had before. I was really worried that they were going to try to maintain the purity of it and really dumb everything down, as Nintendo often does with the things that are outliers. Even with the Majora's Mask 3D update, they kind of brought things closer to more how things are now, trying to keep things what they consider purely Zelda, and I'm really happy that they're willing to let this one wander outside the lines, because that's kind of what made Link's Awakening so good and still one of my absolute favorites of all time. Anyway, to wrap this all up, I am super excited about this. Once again, I have no reservations. This can only be a good thing. Even if the remake itself is disappointing in quality, which I don't see that happening, but even then, I'm still getting more of something that I absolutely love. I've really enjoyed this game. And like I said, it's interesting to see this move from Nintendo, a little more attention to the handheld titles, so I am a little curious as to what their move going forward is. They've been remaking a lot of things, and they've done well enough. My opinion on the handhelds versus the home consoles is that they've kind of been two separate series, right? Once the game kind of diverged from 3D to top-down, the top-downs had their own staples, and the 3D games had their own staples. So it is interesting seeing them remake a handheld 2D game for the Nintendo Switch, and I'm wondering, jumping the gun a little bit here, right now we should just be excited about the actual game, but one thing to consider in the long run is, are they actually going to be doing that with other things? Are we going to see a few more of the top-downs? We saw A Link Between Worlds, which was a fantastic game, and now we're seeing this one. So if they're remaking a bunch of the handheld games, are we going to be looking at a remake of the Oracle games? Or could they, like they did with A Link Between Worlds, have a spiritual successor to those, which, personally, I would absolutely love. Those games are kind of, in my opinion, the pinnacle of the handheld titles. They really pushed what they can with it, and I don't think the handheld games have been as good since then. However, they were made by Capcom, so, you know, they might consider those ones not real Zelda games. I'm not really sure. It is interesting to see what's going to happen, though. Fingers crossed. For now, I'm really looking forward to this remake. I don't pre-order games often. I consider it bad practice. In this instance, I'm probably gonna
bite the bullet and pre-order it. Like I said, I have no reservations, and I am stupid excited for it. I am not affiliated with Nintendo in any way, shape, or form. However, I highly recommend that people both buy this game and play the original one so they can see what it is that it is being compared to. I don't think you'll regret it. While it is very quirky, it is a nice and simple game, and in my opinion, a very, very solid entry in the Zelda series, which is my absolute favorite series. So, not biased at all.